Hello and welcome to Couples in Christ. I am Pastor Tim.
And I'm Patty.
And today we're going to read from Matthew chapter 3, a few selected verses.
So we're going to start with verse 1 and 2. In those days, John the Baptist came preaching in the wilderness of Judea. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And then we're going to move to verse 8, which says, bear fruit in keeping with repentance.
So do you ever find yourself having the same old arguments about the same old things, like, over and over and over again?
We do it at times.
Yeah, and then there's always that moment where we say that we're sorry.
Right, but is that enough?
I would say no. We need true repentance in our relationships.
Repentance isn't just, I'm sorry. Repentance is a complete turnaround, a U-turn, per se.
Yeah, it's moving literally 180, like the opposite direction of what you were doing, and so never to try to do that thing again. So we need to regret what we have done and then change our behavior, like to turn around and do something like the opposite.
Right, and that's exactly what John the Baptist was telling everybody in our passages. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is near.
Yeah.
Jesus is coming. Stop doing what you're doing.
Yeah, and Jesus actually gives us the same message when he shows up on the scene. The very first words out of his mouth is, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand, like right now.
It's here.
In
I'm
him.
Me.
Yeah, right. In me. I'm here. Yeah. Hello. Yeah.
So verse 8 tells us that the proof of our change is in our action.
Let's read verse 8 again.
It says, bear fruit in keeping with repentance. Our fruit is the result of our repentance. When we've repented, our actions, our fruit, show what change.
That we've changed, yep. Yes. So when Christ rules in our hearts and in our minds and in our lives, we do not want to keep committing the same sins over and over and over again.
Instead, we need to ask for divine help to change. We need to ask God to come into our relationships, into ourselves, and help us to change those behaviors.
Yeah, to literally change our hearts and minds, mm-hmm. and the hearts and minds of both of us. Yeah,
this is a vital part of a good relationship is being able to realize, oh crud, I have been doing this and I need to change it. Yeah. Not just, I'm sorry, you know, but, oh, I'm doing the same thing again and it's caused another fight. I need to change it.
Yep. So I guess that's kind of our assignment. It's all of our assignments because this is something we do as couples.
Notice those things, you know, when you have that same argument again about whatever it is, notice, well, what started it and how do we change that thing so we don't have that same old argument again.
Over and over and over again.
Yeah.
And as we always do, prayer is a very vital tool in this resource to help dealing with repentance and bringing your prayers and your sins and your frustrations to God is a good way for God to actually start that change in your life. And so we're going to, like we do every time we have a devotion, we end in prayer. So I encourage you to keep praying as a couple as well. And so let us pray. Lord, I know I need to do more than say, I'm sorry.
I need to turn away from my wrong patterns.
I want to change, but Lord, I need your help.
Please give me the strength to repent, to take that U-turn.
Amen.
Amen.
All right. Well, I think that is it for today, and we will see you again real soon. Have a blessed day in Christ.
Bye, guys.
Bye.